Hi everyone, Ganesh here. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to change the brake pads and the brake discs or the rotors on the VW Polo. This also applies to the Vento and Rapid as well, and basically any other car which utilizes the disc brake system on the front wheels. So let's get started. So the first thing you do is to jack up your car, but before that, slacken all your lug bolts on the front wheels. So the cars are now nicely secured on jack stands on both sides. There you go. Additionally, I just kept this floor jack as a standby. Guys, so you can see in the close-up here that there's a lot of scoring marks on these on this disc brake. Basically, this is a stock disc brake that I've been using from the factory. I've not had to change this so far, and but the brake pads have been changed twice. Once, I believe this was during the 75,000 service, and once very recently during the last lockdown, which I did it at home. Guys, as far as the maintenance of your front brakes go, your manufacturer recommends a minimum wear limit beyond which you have to renew your disc brakes or the rotors completely. Until then, you can have it machined on a lathe and you can do it for a whole lot cheaper. And Volkswagen recommends a minimum wear limit of 19 mm measured across flats before you'll have to renew the disc brake completely. So I'll show you how to do that. You need a vernier caliper or a screw gauge for measuring the thickness, and set the zero. I don't have a very fancy caliper like Mitutoi or something. This is something I got off AliExpress back then. So you need to measure the width across flats here. You can see that the limit is about 22 decimal places. That's in mm. You can go as low as 19 mm before you'll have to discard the rotors completely and get a new batch. You can also use a screw gauge for measurement. So in case your service advisor advises you to change the rotors, ask them to show you what is the thickness of the rotors before you go in for a replacement. So this time I intend to skim this rotor on a lathe. Since I'm at my home, I know a lathe shop. And plus, during the last brake pad service where I changed the brake pads, I did not change some of the bolts and you know, this rubber grommet here and at the bottom right there. This one and these two bolts. So I've got that kit as well, which I'll show you. It'll be a good idea to change, you know, those components as well when you're doing the brake pad service, because it is available as a kit. So I'll show that to you in the meantime. So this is that kit, which is available for, I believe, 880. And I'll give the part number in the description below. Do check it out. So this is basically your brake pad service kit, or what they retail as the bushing. So there you go. This is what you get as a part of this kit here. So now you can see the whole assembly. These are the two bolts. There are guide pins inside. And these are the two bushings. You can see the brake pads here. So this is a whole caliper assembly here, and this is a caliper bracket. So we'll remove this assembly. There's going to be a lot of dust, especially the brake dust, when you're going to clean this using a wire brush. So I advise you to wear something like a good you know, face mask to prevent inhaling all that dust. It's going to be really bad. As for gloves, it's really a personal choice, because you're just going to have to clean it, but you're not going to be dealing with brake fluid or something. I would not want to wear you know, gloves, because I can get a better hold of the things that I'm holding. So I'm not going to use gloves. I'd leave that to the user. But masks is a must, guys. So please wear that. So when it comes to the things you need, you're going to need a lot of you know, clothes. You're going to need
tool kit. This is my personal favorite, a quarter inch drive, some brake cleaners, and you're going to need a big large C-clamp. This is a 120 mm I believe C-clamp for pushing the piston back. And so let's get started, guys. Before that, you know, it'll be a good idea to clean this whole assembly. I have this trusty old wire brush. Use it to, you know, you're going to need a 12 mm socket for this. Place the screws somewhere safe, like this magnetic tray, so you don't lose it. Now once you remove this assembly, you're going to have to hang this somewhere. Remove this and okay, so the next thing is to remove these brake pads. These are like new brake pads, so you can see the condition right here. Has ample thickness. I replaced this back in, I think, about April, May 2021. Remove these two guide pins with the bellows. You're going to need an 18-19 spanner or a socket 18 to have this to remove out. So you can see that the whole disc is now free. This uses a T30 Torx bit to remove this disc out. Plus, we have this caliper guide bolt holes to clean. You can see there's a lot of grease inside these. You would have to clean it properly so it enables the pads to push in properly as they get consumed. Remove these two guide shims. Now look at the condition of this disc brake, guys. I'm going to have to skim it in the lathe once. That'll be the first time I'll be doing it as well. Guys, so we finally managed to get these discs skimmed on a lathe, and I'm so glad that it has lasted this well, this long. You can see the quality of the skimming. There's a little roughness on these. So let me try installing it back one wheel after the other. Guys, so we've got this disc skimmed from a lathe machine, engineering workshop. We'll install it back to the hub. But before that, you need to clean this hub properly. Now, some of them would apply some copper grease, anti-seize copper grease on this hub. Now, I'd go clean. I don't want anything on the mating surfaces. So I've just cleaned it with
piece of sandpaper right here. Just fold the sandpaper. Just give it a nice clean. To get rid of all that dirt. Now, brake cleaners, because they are alcoholic in nature, they'll quickly dry, as you can see. Guys, the next step is to install this caliper bracket into the assembly. But before that, you need to clean these shims. These metal shims help in, you know, gliding those brake pads once the brake pedal is pushed. So you need to ensure that you clean this cavity here and you grease it thoroughly, so it helps in the movement of the brake pad. These shims are held in place right here. So once this is cleaned, I usually use a lot of brake cleaner and WD-40 to get the existing grease back out, and then I apply fresh grease on it. So you need to clean this cavity and place this caliper bracket back into the assembly. You also need to clean these caliper pin guide holes. So this pin is basically this unit right here. It goes into this. So let's install this caliper bracket back into the assembly. Hand tighten the bolts as much as you can. Use the 18 socket or an 18-19 spanner to tighten it. If you have a torque wrench, use that. I do not have the torque wrench with me right now, so I'm at the mercy of this 18-19 ring spanner. So that's a firm fit. Okay, so now the caliper bracket has been installed. Next step is to install this caliper assembly right here. But before that, we need to compress this piston back, so, you know, it gives us sufficient space to install it back into the assembly right here. But before compressing the piston, I suggest just clean it once and the mating surface, because this is a part that's going to mate with the brake pad on the other side, on the inside. So before you attempt to compress this piston, please open the brake fluid reservoir's cap and just keep it aside. There is a likelihood that a little bit of the fluid may flow on the outside, so it's always a good idea to spread some cloth. Just, you know, brake fluid is highly corrosive, so it shouldn't be, you know, it's a very nasty fluid compared to other fluids like engine oil, etc. So we spread it around the cap and open it a bit, and just leave it like that. Now, there are multiple ways in which you can compress this piston in your caliper assembly. The easiest way to do it is to use a C-clamp like this. In my last attempt, I had a smaller C-clamp which was of no avail. So, we had to, you know, devise some jugaad to press the piston back. Now, I have a larger C-clamp which fits the purpose. So, what you need to do is take the brake pad, preferably the older one which you are planning to dispose of. Keep it right there. Just place it like this and start compressing it.
pad is being pushed, and as a result the piston also gets pushed. Yeah, so that's as far as it goes. Take the clamp out, take the pad out, clean the mating surface of the piston. You can see it's a bit greasy. Just clean it a bit with the brake cleaner. Okay, so that's reasonably clean. Now we'll insert the pads and push it back. See, you have these two brake pads. Now, although it looks identical, if you keep it this way, it looks identical, isn't it? But it actually isn't, because you see these rivets, they are not identical. So this particular rivet, this pad is meant for the outside. It comes here like this, whereas this one, where you see these rivets on the outer extremes, this is where that piston is going to compress. You can see the mark impression of the piston head over here. So this is going to come on the inside. Actually, they had specified inside and outside here, but it's gone now. So you have to keep this in mind. Not all brake pads have this. Some of them do. For those who don't, it's going to be symmetrical. For those that have this, please pay attention to what is written. You do not want to mess with this by changing it. Yeah. So please keep that in mind. Basically, the location of the rivets and where these pads have to go. But before installing the brake pads, just ensure that you grease these guide parts of the shims here. Just a wee bit of it. Even if a bit of grease goes into this, the surface of the brake discs, we can clean it, not a problem. Insert the brake pads back. Apply a bit of grease on this surface, because this is going to press against the caliper. Now the next step is the most important one. Here you have got to grease these guide pins. You have these two guide pins. You've got to grease it thoroughly. Guys, just an important thing. You get two of these guide pins. Only one of them has this rubber bushing, which is this. This goes on the top. If you try inserting it on the bottom hole, there will be a bit of compression, and it would just not go. Don't try squeezing it in. It's a very simple indication that this is the one which is meant to go on top. This one goes on the bottom. You can see there's ample play there. Apply the grease on the pin for the top. Push it on top right there. Clean the excess grease. You don't need all that to, attract all the dirt, mud and all that. So try squeezing it. You can see there's a bit of play there. That's how it's meant to be. Now once that's done, just reassemble the caliper back. Now once you've set the caliper in the place, use the newly supplied screws. hand tighten as much as you can. Once you're done tightening these two screws, put the wheel back, and before you start off, just depress the brake pedal multiple times so you know the piston pushes back against this brake pads. You can see a gap there. There's a gap here. The piston is right now compressed. So once you depress the brake pedal, it'll start pushing the pads with the disc, and it'll set the pads in motion. So that's one last step before you start driving off. Guys, before you start driving off, depress the brake pedal several times to let the caliper pistons push against the brake pads sufficiently. Guys, I hope this video was useful. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Stay safe and see you next time.